whatever road you're on, take the next step at Trinity Valley Community College. Founded in 1946 as Henderson County Junior College in Athens, Texas, TVCC has grown through the years and now includes campuses in Palestine, Kaufman, and Terrell in our five-county service area. Taking the first step with anything new can often be the hardest, but our Pathways to Progress will provide you with the support you need in your first year to keep you moving down the right path. From your first day at TVCC, you'll feel like part of the family. Everyone you meet on campus will be focused on helping you succeed. Most of our classes are offered online, allowing you to work towards your goal on your own time at your own pace. Advisors are here to help you decide on your career pathway. Work toward an associate's degree, transfer to a university, improve or change your career, or just take classes for personal enrichment. You can make campus life as busy and rewarding as you want with a full range of activities and organizations available. Discover the important services offered at the Cardinal Success Center, like quiet study rooms, computer access, and one-on-one tutoring. Join your fellow students and community supporters to cheer our championship Cardinal football, basketball, volleyball, softball, cheer, and rodeo teams. One of the highest-rated two-year colleges in America by the Aspen Institute and Smart Asset, TVCC delivers a quality, affordable education, and financial aid is available for those who qualify. Whatever your goal, TVCC will provide you with the tools to be the best you can be. Find your pathway to success at Trinity Valley Community College. Welcome to the Valley, and go Cardinals! Welcome to the Valley. At Trinity Valley Community College, we care about helping you achieve your goals, and we want to see you succeed on your pathway to progress. Whether you want to gain new job skills, work toward a degree, or transfer to a four-year university, TVCC will provide you with the tools to be the best student you can be. Taking the first step with anything new can often be the hardest, but our Pathway to Progress will provide you with the support you need in your first year to keep moving down the right path. First, you'll attend a Cardinal Pride Freshman Orientation session where you'll be welcomed into the Cardinal family by meeting other students, faculty and staff, touring the campus, and learning about ways to get involved. You'll learn about important services offered at the Cardinal Success Center like quiet study rooms, computer access, and tutoring. You'll also get your student ID, parking sticker, and last but certainly not least, register for classes. If you haven't selected your academic pathway yet, our advisors are here to guide you in selecting the right one to meet your goals. From accounting to welding, we've got a program for you. Next, you'll get registered for a Learning Framework class, which is a 3-credit-hour transferable core course designed to teach you success skills that will propel you forward on your pathway to progress in college. You'll learn valuable skills like note-taking, time management, effective communication, personal assessment, and study skills, all things that are essential to lifelong learning and personal growth. With our Pathway to Progress, the objective is to improve student success so that you feel confident in the classroom and on campus where you can focus on achieving your goals. After your first semester is completed, you'll be on the Pathway to Progress, know all the secrets to success at TVCC, and we'll be here to help you every step of the way. Welcome to the Valley, and go Cards! Scramble to get ahead. Let us help you put the pieces in place. Welcome to Trinity Valley Community College Adult Education. Our mission is to assist adults in acquiring the basic academic skills to prepare for examinations such as the TSI, GED, and ASVAB, and brush up on basic academic skills needed for the workplace. English as a second language classes are offered for adults to learn communication skills that will aid them in functioning in the American culture and workforce. E ESL Entrepreneur Seminars provide information to help students in owning and running their own businesses in and around the community. TBCC Adult Education is the first step to your future. Contact us at adulted@tbcc.edu or call us at 903-675-6398 for more information.
Sports Network brings you this special presentation. Event coverage starts now.
Welcome to the Cardinal Sports Network presentation of basketball at Trinity Valley Community College. We are coming to you live from Leon's Mitchell Court at Cardinal Gym, where this afternoon the fourth-ranked Lady Cardinals take on the Coastal Bend Lady Cougars. Lady Cardinals bring an 8-2 mark into the contest. They are 5-2 in conference play. Coastal Bend is 1-8 on the season and 1-4 in conference play. I'm Benny Rogers, Sports Information Officer here at the college, and I'm joined like always by my buddy from KTV Radio and Tyler, Tim Howard. And Tim, on paper, mismatch. Lady Cardinals beat Coach Ben down there 106-46 first time around. But the Lady Cardinals are back in the situation where they've only got 7 players in uniform tonight.
Yeah, that's going to take a lot of strategy to just get into the rhythm of your bench and your rotation. Plus, when you consider the fact they're 2-5 in their last 5 contests. Now, they had an explosive win the other night, pretty strong, and they're without a couple of players, obviously, with that short bench. But you just can't have any real mistakes or any more injuries. That would really hurt.
Yeah, a couple weeks ago, we saw the Lady Cardinals take on Kilgore here. It was 7 players and won that game by a score of 75-64. So it's doable.
Sure.
It's very doable. You have to be real careful early on about the foul situation, of course.
Yeah.
Because that affects your rotation. I don't even call it a rotation with just 2 players on the bench.
I was going to say, the Lady Cougars, if they're onto their game, they're going to attack. They're going to try to get the Lady Cards in foul trouble.
I mentioned the first time around the Lady Cards won 106-46. At halftime, the Lady Cards were up 54-28 in an explosive first half. Lady Cardinals come in averaging 79.8 points a game, giving up 56.4. Coastal Bend comes in scoring 58.8, and here's the trouble spot for Coastal Bend. They're giving up 89.2.
Yeah, you're going to be hard-pressed to get any wins when you're giving up 90 points a game.
It's a lot of pressure on your offense.
It really does. So we'll look forward to what the Cards have going this afternoon.
I mentioned the Lady Cards are ranked number 4th in the last poll. That's probably there's going to be an adjustment made to that. The Lady Cardinals are 1-1 in games this week, having lost to Panola Monday night 67-65 in overtime. And then, of course, won by a count of 110-60 here Wednesday night over Bossier Parish.
And as the Lady Cards get things going, they want to come out to that quick start, get off the run, and like you said, really get that momentum going and move back up in region 14.
Yeah, and in terms of wins, Lady Cardinals just 1 game behind Panola, and then, of course, they dropped the game to Panola. This coming week is a big week as we keep the standings up. It's a big week for the Lady Cardinals. On Wednesday night, they go to Glenn. You see Glenn's record right there. It's 3-1 in conference play, 7-3 overall. And then next Saturday here in the game we have on the Carver Sports Network, they play Tyler. And Tyler beat number 25 the first time around.
Yeah, that was a tough night out there for the Lady Cards.
And then, oh, by the way, the following Wednesday, they play Panola in a rematch of the loss this week.
So it might be an understatement the next week and a half. It's going to be a juggernaut of part of the season, the Lady Cards. Want to come out and get focused on this one and really get some momentum going into the next three.
No question about that. And you want to get some players back too. It's unlikely that Tiana Jackson is going to be back in time for any of those three games, as is Tania Jackson. I'm hoping to have Taylor Hutchins back, but still they're going to be shorthanded going to that tough three-game stretch. The good news is two of the three are home.
And absolutely, that does make a lot of difference. And, you know, talking about road travel, that takes its impact. Coastal Bend, that's not a nice little leisure drive, is it? They're, how far away are they? Coming in about 8 hours?
About 8 hours, yes, down in B-ville. Of course, we saw Coastal Bend men in here on this past Wednesday night taking on the Cardinals, and the Cardinals won that one. Now, Coastal Bend softball was here for a three-game set Thursday and Friday. They didn't go too well for Coastal Bend. Lady Cards won by 8-0 scores in all three games.
That's congrats to the Lady Cards softball squad. They put some stuff together for Well, that team. Always love to see what's going on.
Well, you can call them Bash Brothers, so to speak. Man, they are slapping home runs after going out of style.
Have you been down at the cages? Is that what I heard? That rumor is true, man, evidently. And Benny's been giving tips down in the softball.
I will never be accused of giving any tips.
Okay. Making sure. Just make sure.
Coastal Bend comes in shooting a very low percentage, 30.8 from the floor, which is not good at all. Free throw percentage-wise, if they're good, it's 71.4, and three-point range of 25%. Lady Cardinals are shooting 41.7 from the floor, 59% from free throw range. That's not good. They need to be up there about 65 or 70. In the three-point range, they're hitting 28% of their shots.
That's going to make it tough on them for sure. And as you're game planning here, what are they saying? They're loose and they're on the floor right now. But what were the words that the Lady Cougars were hearing today? So how do you attack Trinity Valley? What's the game plan?
You're in a no-lose situation. Nobody expects you to win. So go swing from the hill.
Yeah.
It was Lady Cards got off to a slow start down at B-ville, but then once they kicked it in. And we're about a minute and a half, folks, getting this one underway. The Lady Cardinals have come over to the sideline here, the bench area, to talk to Precious Ivy and Princess Davis, the coaching staff, to get some last-minute instructions. And we got a doubleheader for you. We get the second game today, Tim, ought to be a really good one. We got the men playing the Barrow in a rematch of the game.
It's always fun to watch those two go at it. The Cards have had their number. We'll talk a little bit more about that in the last, but you know, they're going to have a bounce back today.
Nathan Firstwell coaching for Chase Coach and Lady Cooper. This is the fourth season. Chris Travis in her second season here in college. Having taken over the midseason last year. And she is 25-2 in the second half. That's pretty good.
That's a great start. And, and you factor in the weirdness of how some of those games have come through. I mean, pandemic last year, the season kind of cut short. You know, so I think that's a little misleading. It's incredible.
So it really is. Lady Cardinals last out of 69 exactly where they came away with 8-39 in the after the first quarter and only gave up 14 points in the second half.
So we'll look forward to that as we get close to tip-off.
We're about to turn it over to our athletic director and PA announcer for today's games, Eddie Kite, for the introduction of the national anthem and the starting lineups for both teams. So we'll now turn it over to Eddie
Kite. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Leon Spencer Court at the historic Cardinal Gymnasium on the campus of Trinity Valley Community College for today's matchup with Coastal Bend Cougars versus your Lady Cardinals in a Region 14 conference matchup. At this moment, will you please stand? Gentlemen, please remove your cover as the Cardinal Regiment plays the national anthem.
Thank you.
Riojas is averaging 6.5 points and 6.1 rebounds. She's got 5 3-pointers. Wheeler's averaging 4.1 assists a game. Yarder's averaging 11 points a game coming into the contest. Coastal Bend 1-8 overall, 1-4 in conference play. Alexis is averaging 4.4 points a game. Maylin's averaging 12.1 points a game and has hit 28 3-pointers. Mahogany's averaging 9 points and 7.3 rebounds a game. Kay's averaging 13.9 points, 5.8 rebounds, and 3.6 assists. Michaela is averaging 11 points a game, and there you have the starting lineups. The Lady Cardinals 8-2 overall, 5-2 in conference play. It is Region 14 Conference Basketball. It is Trinity Valley. It is Coastal Bend. Ready for another one here today, folks, on this beautiful afternoon in Athens, Texas. The temperature is probably, what, Tim, about in the mid-60s or thereabouts?
Yeah, about. I think it's about 60 degrees warmer than it was 3 weeks ago.
No doubt about that.
It's probably just about. Yeah, it is gorgeous today. And looking ready forward here to a wonderful afternoon of basketball in Athens.
Mahogany Williams will jump for the Lady Cards, doing the honors for the Lady Cougars will be number 2, Rehaus. And we're about ready to be underway here in Region 14 Conference basketball action. The tip is going to go to the Lady Cards. It's going to be goes to Alexis Brown, controlling the offense. Gives it up to Kay Clark. Kay drives the baseline. Kay lays it up, and Kay lays it in.
Love the fact that Kay immediately noticed there's no one on me. Get the ball pushed, and they got it over there, took it to the hoop, and got the easy bucket.
Cubs in the pressure defense go to sleep on the back end, and the Cougars cannot get the answer. And they're on the run. Hutchinson gives it up to Malin Wilkerson. Wilkerson lays it up. He will not fall. Wilkerson battles for the rebound. Pulls it back out. Kicks it back out to Kay. Kay goes inside to Mahogany. Mahogany kicks it out to Kay. Back over to Malin. Malin for three. Malin Wilkerson for three.
One more ball movement. Rumble and go there. Getting the ball around the perimeter and making the Cougars pass.
Kayla Hudson is going to be called for the foul in the middle. That's what the Lady Cardinals have got to be careful with. Three tag fouls early on that will add up and cause pressure to have a headache with only two players on her bench.
Yeah, and I heard from the bench beforehand, no foul, yeah. So they're all cognizant of it. Sometimes that energy just reaches and instinct took over there.
Noelle Yancey is going to check in for Michaela Hutchinson. Those two transferred in from Stephen F. Austin, so they were teammates a year ago down in Nacogdoches. And Noelle's been starting, but Precious had to kind of adjust things a little bit tonight to account for the fact that there could be some foul problems that the team's going to get into.
That foul actually going to be on 23, so Hutchinson picks it up. They corrected it on the board, but Lady Cards definitely want to stay out of foul trouble here.
Three-pointer on the way. No good. Rebound goes to Mahogany Williams. She's the only one underneath to get it. Kay kicks it out to Maylin. Maylin kicks it over to Noel. Back out top to Kay. Over to Alexis. Alexis puts up three. Alexis Brown for three.
Alexis Brown on point with that three, and it's 8-0 here in the first minute 10.
Lady Carter's in their half-court trap. And they come away with the steal. Noel with the steal gives it up to Alexis. Alexis lays it up, and Alexis lays it in.
Nice start here. A great start for the Cards. Keeping pressure and turning it into easy points on the other side.
Almost another steal by Noel. Coastal Bend down the floor now. Lady Cardinals defending.
Great job getting back to force him into half-court offense.
Three-pointer's good. Number 21 knocks it down.
Great shot. Giardo. Yarda stepped up with confidence with that one. Nice touch.
So it's a 10-0 Lady Cardinals start in this one. Now 10-3. Three-pointer on the way. No good. This time the rebound goes to Noelle Yancey. She puts it up and is blocked, but she puts it back up again and gets the bucket. Noelle Yancey.
Noelle gets the put back after the slight concussion. Speaking of concussion, welcome to Press Row.
Lord, if Kay had got a hand on that, it would be right in my lap. I'm just now getting healthy from an injury. The last thing I need to do is be diving away from basketball.
Good effort from Kay there. I'm going to tell her next time, just let that one go. That would have been a little.
12-3.
Great hustle.
Lady Cards.
I do love the energy they come out firing here.
Three-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound's going to be a long one. It's going to go to Maylin Wilkerson. Wilkerson on the run. She gives it up to Mahogany Williams. Mahogany lays it up and in.
Great reach just to go up over the top and good awareness underneath.
For the Lady Cardinals, with only seven players in the uniform, and they've had five that have already scored. There's a steal and a bucket now. It's going to go to Maylin Wilkerson. It's going to be Alexis Brown with the pass.
Beautiful execution on the trap. They are running it textbook right now. Look at good
shot on the way. No good. Rebound goes to Maylin Wilkerson. Lady Cardinals quickly on the run.
Making them work.
Maylin Wilkerson for three. Oh, kind of stuck her like a plum.
It looked like I shot that one.
It's Tim Halbert to get out there and jump up and get the ball.
We're going
to
be here a while.
There we go.
16-3 start, though. You can't draw it up any better than that.
Number 34, Miranda Leon.
And they have made the Cougars work in difficult circumstances here at that 1-3, the only basket thus far.
Three-pointer on the way. No good. Rebound goes to Anderson. Deanna pulled the rebound. Kay Clark. Alexis Brown for three. We have set a record here tonight for step basketball.
I'm going to say, we've had some memorable moments here in the Valley.
It just stuck there.
Nobody's in the Sanders. No,
let the record show Tim Howard did not get out of his seat and attempt to go get that one.
I let the record show I actually fastened my seatbelt just in case.
Lady Cards will inbound. Get it in to Kiana. She knocks, lays it up and lays it in. Kiana Anderson, her first points of the contest. Great inbounds play for the Lady Cardinals. Lady Cardinals are in full gear here on defensively. Yancey with the steal. Yancey kicks it out to Maylin. Maylin gets it up to Kay. Kay does a little bit too much with it, and the Lady Cards turn it over.
Go back to that previous entrance pass. Good patience, just letting it develop right in front of and then finding the entrance.
Jumper on the way, no good. Rebound goes to Kiana.
They just keep coming.
Maylin's pushing the ball, as you heard Precious Ivy exulting in the background. Lady Carr swinging the basketball pretty good around the perimeter. Alexis Brown for three, no good. Rebound goes long, and Kay Clark's going to run it down.
Kay will hustle right there.
Case kicks it out to Noel Yancey. Noel Yancey for three. Noel Yancey for three.
On the money with that. Again, they come up with a big basket.
Lady Cards now with 3 three-pointers in the contest. Coach Ben quickly down the floor, doing a nice job of getting down the floor with number 10, Martinez. She's averaging 7 points a game.
Yeah, I'm going to give Martinez good awareness there, giving the look-off pass. There was no one there to pass to, but she faked it and went to the basket, got the bucket.
We are at 21-5. Timeout, Lady Cards. It's going to be turned into a media timeout, so we'll step away briefly and rejoin you on the other side at 5-14 left in the opening quarter. Out of the media timeout, the Lady Cardinals up 21-5. 5 has been all late in Carter, but jumped out to a 10-0 lead stretch to 16-3. It is now 21-5. Five, still halfway to go in this first quarter.
What an effort, man, getting it going out right off the block here. You're up 21 in the first half of the first quarter.
Goodness. Anderson gives it up to Hutchinson. Hutchinson lays it up and in. That's textbook basketball right there.
And you're seeing a lot of, execution. I mean, these plays, and it's all, a lot of it's happening off of the fast break. Watch it get a turnover there, turn it into points. So it could be explosive in a hurry.
The Cardinals doing a great job on the ball today. Three-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound's going to go long to Kiana. Kiana kicks it out to Kay. Eddie Carter sitting up there, look like they're in motion on offense. Oh, nice job. Let's just do it again.
Powers her way to the basket, going to the free throw line.
This time, Michaela Finn, Kiana. Kiana couldn't get it to fall, but goes to the free throw line. This is the area the Lady Cardinals have struggled this year at the free throw line. They've had some terrible free throw shooting contests.
They really want to improve here over the next few moments.
Well, no, like today.
Well, yeah. I mean, leading up for the whole tournament, you've got to. Got to get those. Those are freebies. Charity point. Charity strike.
Straighten your body and move to your left was Precious Ivy's suggestion to her. Well, it didn't work.
Got the rebound, though. See if they can keep that momentum going here.
Kay with a power move. Lays it up and lays it in. Kay Clark now with 4 points in the contest.
Nice work from Kay. Moving quickly to the basket.
Three-pointer on the way, knocked it down, number 34, three-pointer, Miranda Lamb. She had 13 three-pointers coming into the contest.
Lamb, a freshman out of San Marcos.
So six of Coastal Bend's 8 points have been on three-pointers. Doyle Yancey with a runner along the baseline, no good. Battle one for the rebound is Hutchinson, but she can't come away with it. Keanu Anderson gets a piece of the ball, though, and gets a held ball, and possession error belongs to Coastal Bend.
A good effort there, but like you said, that arrow point in the other direction.
Small crowd in here today for this one. We think there are a few more folks will come in, but there's a beautiful weather day here in Athens.
And it's been a while since we've had gorgeous weather like this. And so
Mahogany Williams checking into the contest for Kiana Anderson. Of course, Mahogany Williams is the stepsister of Leticia Nunu Dean, a two-time All-American the last 2 years here at the college.
Look at the work there, and it's going to pay off. Well,
Hutchinson batted for the steal and winds up getting the ball over to Mahogany. The ball goes out of bounds, but it does go out of bounds off of Coastal Bend.
So they catch a break there. I think it converted into points.
Kay Clark for three. No good. Rebound goes to Michaela. Michaela gives it up to Noel. Noel with the jumper. Noel knocks it down.
That basket, that was just nice. Form going up strong and putting it down for two.
Noel now with 7 points to lead the Lady Cards, and she did not start the game today. She did come in pretty quickly, though.
Making her presence known here.
27-8. Lady Cards had a 34-point first quarter against Bossier Parish. Nice job by Mahogany Williams controlling her body after taking the pass.
Mahogany averaging 9 points a game. Got a nice look there to get two of them.
Alexis Brown's going to check back into the contest for the Lady Cards. Three-pointer on the way. This one's no good. Rebound's going to go to Hutchinson. Lady Cardinals are running the floor and wheel, Tim.
Boy, they are. Look at that textbook there. Covering the ball up, but just didn't finish.
Did everything but finish. Three-pointer on the way. In and out.
It's one and done for Coastal Bend. They're not even getting in the paint.
Noel Yancey for three, no good. Kay Clark battles for the rebound and puts
That's
it up. And looked like it went off the shot clock, but it doesn't go in nonetheless. But she will go to the free throw line to shoot two.
That was all energy there to get that loose ball on the rebound. I mean, she just all open the floor. Okay.
And to the official's credit, Tim, that's just the third foul called in this contest.
Yeah, there.
I do it every time.
2:26 to go in the first quarter. Benny referenced the.
I did it. It's all on me, folks. I've been around long enough to know that you don't do that.
So
somebody's got to do it.
I was right behind you about to do it anyway. So,
first free throw attempt is no good. Lady Cards now 0-for-3 from the free throws line. Something they've got to get cleaned up.
You and I both have talked on that, and it's one of those things you've got to improve on.
And the second one is no good, but there's Hutchinson for the rebound. Putback is no good. The Lady Cardinals come away empty.
Wow. 0-for-4 on free throw attempts thus far. That's the Achilles heel right now. The only glaring point of this one.
That in depth are the two things that are concerning me the most about the Lady Cardinals as we move forward.
You've really got to.
Kay's going to be caught with a foul. They had to call that. I thought he was going to overlook it. I guess he got to thinking, I can't be that obvious.
I think at 2:26 of this broadcast here in the first quarter, someone mentioned.
Yeah, well.
It's all the same.
You remember too much.
29-8, though, 2:13 to go. Finish his last 2 minutes strong and complete that quarter. You know, I mean, with some free throws, that would be a great.
Herschel Ben gets the ball in, goes into his half court attack. Any great size on this Coastal Bend team, so everything's dictated around the perimeter. There's a turnover now. Kiana with the steal lays it up, and Kiana lays it in. And the weight on that one gets a second.
That all around that cylinder. Thought about bouncing out.
It hung up there. So Lady Cardinals were close to matching that 34 points they put up against Bossier Parish, who hung in the last 10 times. The runner's no good, and the foul's going to be called. It's going to be an offensive foul, so a great job of the Lady Cardinals drawing the player control foul, and the ball will go the other way. And Alexis Brown will inbounds for Lady Cards.
Yeah, I got those feet set and just in outside the circle there. So he's able to draw the charge. And now they got a chance, like I said, to dive into that 34 they had the other night.
Give the ball down to Kiana. She gives it up to Mahogany. Mahogany lays it up. They can't get it to fall. Battles for the rebound. Gets the put back, it won't fall. Puts another foot put back, high off the glass, and it falls. Credit Mahogany Leaves for staying with that team.
Yeah, battle down low, got a couple of rebounds, couple of looks at it, makes the most of it. Two for Williams. She's now got six here in the first quarter.
Turnover, so Lady Cardinals now have the chance to top that 34-point quarter that they had at home the last time around, and that was a 60-point win.
I was going to say, you've got to feel pretty good about the chances here today.
Michaela drives, gives it up to Kiana. Kiana lays it up, and Kiana lays it in. Now Kiana with 6 points in the contest. 35-8 Lady Cards, under a minute to go in the first quarter.
Pretty evenly distributed on the points for the Lady Cards.
Three-pointer on the way. She might have been just inside the stripe. She was just inside the stripe, so it was not a three-pointer. Hutchinson, pull-up jumper, no good. Kiana with the rebound, kicks it back out to Alexis. Lady Cardinals can run off most of the time that's remaining in the first quarter if they decide to. Michaela Hutchinson gives it up to Mahogany. Mahogany makes a move inside, steps back, misses the little short jumper. Another turnover going to the Lady Cards.
5 seconds.
Mahogany can get it to fall, and Kiana is too late to get it to fall. So it's going to be 35-10 Lady Cars into one. We'll step away briefly and rejoin you in the start of the second quarter. Moving play after one quarter here. Leon's Christmas Cardinals team is all Lady Cardinals. Lady Cards 35, posted in. Tim, your thoughts of the first quarter?
Just excellent effort all the way around at 99.9% of the free throw line. Still a challenge right now, but you know, a long way to go here. Something to prove at the strike.
Lady Cards went 0-4 from the free throw line, I think, in the first quarter. So it could have been a 40-point quarter, essentially.
Yeah. So that's a great start. 35 points per quarter.
So we'll see what pace the Lady Cards can go at here in this second quarter. Quickly swinging the ball and throwing it out of bounds. Alexis Brown throws her hands up in disgust. She thought she'd made a good pass. Coastal Bend quickly moving the ball up the floor. Then they run into the Lady Cardinal trap. And it's giving them all kind of fits here in this contest. There you see it right there in front of us.
Good ball movement.
It really was good ball movement. But a good job of the Lady Cardinal to respond with the pressure. They come down with the rebound and quickly go on the attack. Michaela Hutchinson for three, short. Alexis gives it up to Michaela. Michaela lays it up. Michaela lays it in. Nice feed by Alexis Brown.
Brown going to get to the basket with that. Gives her, what she got on the afternoon? Is that eight or four? Excuse me.
Nice job of spinning down low. The number 12, Savannah Smith, but she comes away with no points.
Anderson, another rebound for the Lady Cards.
Actually, number 12, Smith, is averaging 16 points a game, and the leading scorer for Coastal Bend is Kiana Anderson, lays up the shot.
She's got eight in the afternoon here.
She's now the leading scorer for the Lady Cards. As Tim mentioned, it is a balanced scoring attack for the Lady Cards. My precious Ivy's about to be 2-for-2 and not foul, no foul, and getting a foul at all.
Yeah, with it right in front of us, we always get to see that.
Number 10, Chicken, got this Brianna Martinez for the Lady Cougars, along with number 34, Lamb hit 13 three-pointers on the season.
We're going to have to get her going here.
And we need to get a lot going.
A lot, I was going to say, maybe a couple of five-pointers at him. Good start for Trinity Valley this afternoon.
Oh, my goodness, I thought she was about to get a miraculous shot to fall. Malin Wilkerson's going to lay it up. It's going to be fouled. She'll go to the free throw line. It's not been the Lady Cards' best friend here on the season, especially in this game where they were for four.
Glad to see her bounce back up because she took that hard. And anytime you're looking around with a seven-man rotation, seven-man squad, you hate to see those hard fouls.
Malin gets a free throw to fall. She now has 6 points in the contest. One three-pointer included. Second free throw attempt is good. So nice job by Malin Wilkerson of stopping the Lady Cardinals' struggles from the free throw line.
2 of 6.
That's a real nice job of getting the ball. Oh, my goodness, what a block by Kay Claw.
Kay's out of business as soon as she gets a block. No time for somebody. Just gets right back in there and gets ready to go. I love it.
Man, she just blocked the heck out of that.
Clark's one of the toughest all-around players defensively. Boy, she's so
she's one of the best defensemen to ever come through here, and I don't just throw that around for anybody.
She's earned that for sure.
There's a steal by Kiana Anderson. It's going to be a shot clock violation, so nonetheless, it's going to be the defense for the Lady Cardinals coming away with a turnover.
Love seeing that. Again, keeping that fire burning, keeping, making them work for everything.
Lady Cards have outscored Coastal Bend 6-0 here early in the second quarter. Three-pointer on the way by Maylin, no good. Maylin's cooled off after hitting that first one. The Lady Cardinals haven't cooled off. And there's Alexa. I mean, Noelle Yancey getting a block.
Yancey almost knocked that out on her. It could have been very easily out of bounds by Coastal Bend.
It almost went that way. Kay Clark playing passing lane, comes away with a turnover, and the Lady Cards quickly go on the move, getting it down the floor to Malin Wilkerson. She gives it up to Kiana. Kiana with the wild shot that doesn't fall. Kiana with the putback now that won't fall. Kiana with another putback that won't fall.
Oh, my.
And finally, on the fourth try, Kiana Anderson knocks it down.
I'm looking down at the bench there. There's going to be some subs coming into the game for the Cougars.
Shot lays up and goes in. Keanu's leading the Lady Cards with 10 points in the contest. Probably leading in shots, too, after that series.
I think she took as many in that possession as...
That's a good inside-out game right there by the Lady Cardinals. Don't Alexis stop. Brown with a move, but the problem is she took too many steps.
Too many moves on that. I was trying to get that jump some. I think she shuffled both feet as she's coming down there, so it definitely was travel there.
Keanu Anderson checks out of the contest with 10 points. She does lead the Lady Cardinals, but it is a very balanced scoring attack for the Lady Cardinals. No Lady Cardinal has scored less than 4 points. Great job of Kay Carter getting a piece of the ball. Alexis almost comes away with a steal. Lady Cardinals are really working on defense.
They really are.
Runner lays it up, no good. And there's Mahogany Williams with a big power rebound.
Williams tough in the paint.
Quickly down the floor, Clay Clark with Stucky, and she will go to the free throw line.
Oh, man, just making it look easy as he gets to the basket there and draw the foul. So Clay Clark can't go for a three-point finish.
45-12 Lady Cards. At halftime of the previous game, when these two teams played, Tim, the score was 54-28.
That's a big difference. There, as you look up, the Cards are up 34 with 6 minutes to go in the half.
Noel Yancey gets a hand on the ball, but the ball goes out of bounds off of Noel. I really like Noel Yancey. She's been a great addition to the Lady Cardinal program from Stephen F. Austin University. She's out of Richardson, Texas.
Another one of those quality.
She's a quiet player. I mean, she doesn't do anything flashy, but when you look up into the night, she's had a good game both on both ends of the floor.
Consistently does it too.
Lady Carter's have really worked really solid defensively tonight. There's only been a couple of lapses that I've actually noticed, and I'm no trained expert.
You're definitely putting in the effort, putting out that energy today.
Noel Yancey for three. Noel Yancey for three.
Love seeing that, because after that collision right in front of us a couple of moments ago, she was really holding that right hand and working it, but she steps up and hits the three there. Easy.
There's a steal by Maylin Wilkerson. She's going to lay it up and lay it in. Maylin now with 9 points in the contest. Lady Carter led for Keanu Anderson and Noel Yancey with 10 each, and Noel Yancey's got 2 three-pointers.
Halfway to the six.
Maylin Wilkerson with the steal, but player dribbled right into her. Alexis Brown's going to lay it up and lay it in. And I don't know what Coach Perswell's going to do down there, but he might have to start doing it.
He's got about two players about to come in. But
Lady Carr scored 54 points in the game in Coach down in Beeville. And they're at 53 with 4:41 left in this first half. That's
different. It does. Which, don't get me wrong, 54 is a nice number at a half.
We're going to have a media timeout at the 4:41 mark. It is all Lady Cardinals, 53-12 here in the second quarter, and we'll step away and rejoin you out of this timeout. Resuming play out of the media timeout is Lady Cardinals 53-12 on the coast of Penn here at Leon's 54-5. Tim Howard. And Tim, the Lady Cardinals are cooking on defense. Let's just set the record
straight
there.
They are.
But the Lady Cardinals are executing extremely well on the defensive end.
I don't know, Guy Fieri or Emeril Lagasse, bam. I mean, they are playing some ball today. 53-12 with that D working, getting big chunks of it on the transition.
So let's see what Coastal Bend can do coming out of the timeout. Mahogany Williams anticipates the pass and comes away with the steal.
Steps in front.
Alexis Brown, a little far out for the three, kicks it over to Kay. Kay kicks it out to Maylin Wilkerson. Maylin Wilkerson for three. Maylin Wilkerson for three.
And she is just lighting it up from beyond the arc there.
She now has two in the game, 30 on the season. That was just a struggle for Coastal Bend.
Except for a long afternoon. Good hands to keep it.
Pretty good pass from Kay. Maylin Wilkerson for three. This one's no good. Mahogany Williams battles for the rebound, puts it up and puts it in. Mahogany Williams. Lady Cardinals need a bunch more of that the rest of the season.
Yeah, get that confidence going for sure.
Oh, that's an easy call.
Got bailed out there. I think she was going to travel. She pulled it down. Unfortunately, got fouled.
Fouls against Mahogany Williams. That's going to be her first personal foul, team first. Maylin. I'm sorry. Michaela Hutchinson will check into the contest. Number 23. Another transfer from Stephen Foster. Kay Clark, stop if you heard us before, Tim. Gets a hand on the ball.
Well, Kay Clark, I think I'm going to have to double check. That may be her 1,213th time to do that.
It could be something like that in her career, that's for sure.
She's all over the court.
She was a big reason Lady Carters went 32-1 last season in a shortened season because of the pandemic.
Well, That's still a tough pill to swallow when you think about that and how that just everything came to a halt, you know?
Oh. Kay Clark with a block, a massive block.
That was a thunder slam there.
Nice little runner on the baseline. It's going to go unanswered by number 4, Asia Wheeler. Lady Cards quickly down the floor, and a nice job by number 12 getting a piece of the ball, Savannah Smith. So a nice sequence there for the Coastal Bend on defense. And Noelle Yancey's going to pick up the foul on the other end.
Yeah, that's a big turn of events here because going back moments ago, Clark had her second block of the game and then looked like it's going to lead to points.
Tim, I was going to say, as I look at the frame of what's on the screen, that Cardinal Country on that wall looks extra special this year, doesn't it? That wall was blank last year, and Cardinal Country now has been painted on that wall.
Makes
it really looks nice in here.
Yeah, it continued to add touches along the way. I love the Cardinal logos under the stands and the banners and that kind of thing. It really, it's really tightening it up.
Asia Wheeler hit a three-pointer for Coastal Bend on the other end. Kay Clark misses one for the Lady Cardinals. Hits you back up on the action. It's 58-15 Lady Cardinals at the 240 mark. Lady Cardinals looking at possibly a 60-point half. Nice little runner, no good. Well, I tell you, I'm a little bit impressed there with Savannah Smith. I can see how she's averaging 16 points a game. Another steal by the Lady Cardinals. Lady Cardinals quickly going to attack. Michaela Hutchinson drives baseline and puts it up and puts it in.
Excellent job that time to get to the basket. And it started on the other end with Clark keeping her composure with two Lady Cougars all over. They got the thing running, got a baseline drop there.
60-15 Lady Cards. Jumper runner on the way.
Nice touch.
Knocked it down by number 11, Haley Graves.
Graves with a nice baseline shot.
Michaela does a nice job of finding, I'm sorry, Maylin does a nice job of finding Michaela breaking towards the goal, but the pass goes unrewarded. Turnover goes to the Coastal Bend.
Lady Cards have really pulled off here, Benny. They're not going to get that 140 clip that I had penciled in.
Don't give up on it just yet. Maylin lays it up. Maylin gets it to fall. Maylin Wilkerson now with 14 points in the first half. She leads the Lady Cardinals.
Yeah, they have played about as well as you can in the half.
Had a nice little jump runner by Wheeler that gets the layup.
Savannah Smith, timeout, Coastal Bend.
Coastal Bend's going to call a timeout. We're going to keep it here. The first time around, Kay Clark against Coastal Bend. Kay Clark led the Lady Cardinals to 27, and Keon Anderson had 26.
Wow.
Lady Cardinals also had Maylin Wilkerson, Michaela Hutchinson, Mahogany Williams, double digits with 18-15.
And then, about here this
seen here today and much of this.
So well, I mean, it's not just getting the turnover, but in stride, getting to the basket, making quick points on that transition. It makes very difficult to come in here and take a W away
from the Cardinals. So we're back to play now with just about a minute to go now in the first quarter, or the first half, I should say. Lady Cardinals up 62-19. Layden Wilkerson for three, in and out, no good. Rebound goes to the Lady Cougars. Lady Cougars now on the run. And a few times they push the ball down the floor at that pace today. Of course, the Lady Cardinals back out of their half-court trap as well.
And you know, work with your feet here and play D with your feet. Your coach saying don't reach.
Three-pointer on the way, knocked it down. Number 11 with another three-pointer, Haley Graves. Haley's now got five points in the contest. This is her first three-pointer. She had the other one just inside the line. Lady Cardinals quickly down the floor, wild pass. Mahogany lays it up and can't get it to fall. Kiana's going to lay it back up, and Kiana's going to get the bucket.
That cleared out nicely for her after she took a couple of Lady Cards with her on the rebound, and then the effort easy on the other side.
So that's going to be the first half. We've got all Lady Cardinals. Lady Cardinals 64, Coastal Beach 22. We are at Leon's Pitcher Court at Carter Gym for the first half of Region 14 Conference Women's Basketball. We're going to step away and be back when the second half begins. Thank you for joining us here today on the Cardinal Sports Network. Welcome back to the Cardinal Sports Network presentation of basketball at Trinity Valley Community College. We are coming out of halftime with the Lady Cardinals up 64-22 over Coastal Bend. Then all Lady Cardinals in the first half. We'll take a look at the Lady Cardinals scoring. They were led by Bailey Wilkerson with 14. Gianna Anderson had 12. Noelle Yancey had 10. But Hockney Williams had 8. Kay Clark had 7, Alexis Brown had 7, and Michaela Hicks had 6. All the players that have played in the contest scored in the contest can do quite well.
Yeah, they did. Somehow, if you're in that Lady Cougar sideline, you got to keep them moving.
Well, we're about ready to see what they're going to do here. Lady Cardinals put up 64 points in the half, leading 64-22. They came in averaging 79.
I think they're on their way to that average in the first 38 seconds. maybe not. But, yeah, and, of course, for Trinity Valley, get out of this thing healthy, stay active, don't get into bad habits or patterns.
Coastal Bend with the basketball to start the second half of this Region 14 Conference Contest. Lady Cardinals 51 to the trap defense.
Pressure not even.
Kayla Hudson with the steal. Going to lay it up and lay it in. Kayla now with 8 points in the contest. Lady Cardinals have a chance to get all 5-7 players in double digits, Tim.
That's an impressive stat. I mean, not a lot of teams can say, hey, our whole team got into double figures. So here, 9:27 to go, and the Lady Cards out to that quick start here. 11-2.
Coastal Bend on the attack. Little runner, no good. This is everything. Lady Cardinals quickly responding, moving the ball down the floor. Over to Kay. Kay gives it up inside of Mahogany. Mahogany lays it up, can't get it to fall.
She almost reached over two players.
There's a steal by Alexis Brown. Alexis with the pull-up jumper. She can't get it to fall. Mahogany tips the rebound to Alexis. Michaela Wilkerson, I'm sorry, Maylin Wilkerson knocks down the three, but she can't get it to fall. Alexis Brown's going to try her luck from three. She can't get it to fall.
Pretty cold start there around the perimeter that time.
Everybody got a shot.
Everybody got a chance.
It's kind of like the Texas State Fair. Hey, step right up and take a shot.
Nice drive in response by Zapata.
Zapata does a real thing. Real fancy, just put the head down, goes strong, and gets points.
64-22 at the half. It is now 66-24. Both teams have scored. Ball goes inside of Mahogany. Mahogany kicks it back out to Michaela Hudson. Hudson lays it up for three. Can't get it to fall. She didn't quite lay it up, folks, so she shot it.
Foul on training rounds. Mainly in Wilkerson.
Well, it's
first.
Been kind of a flat start for the Lady Cardinals after that initial steal by Michaela Hudson.
Yeah, Nick, going back to that steal, it felt like the Lady Cougars thought there was pressure on the coming in that trap. It never came. It's like one side, and she turned right into it. And they looked up and was like, that was a one-man trap.
Lady Cardinals continuing to work on the defensive end. Alexis Brown almost comes away with the steal. Kay Clark stuck her hand in there and causes a turnover just by the fact that she stuck her hand in the passing line.
It's those little things like that that don't show up in the box score. And she's always such a part of it.
Alexis Brown directing the offense. Gives it up to Kay. Let's go, oh! Let's go, oh! Hey, gets it up to Michaela. Michaela drives. Yeah, the ball is going to be stripped, and she's going to be called for a travel. So it's not been pretty here to start the second half.
That would be the hardest part, I think, if you're in Lady Cardinals camp to come out after such a, you know, 64-point half and then come out, pick it right up for you.
Three-pointer no good, and the Hard Lady Cardinals kicked it up over the top of the rim and lays it up and then draws the foul. Hodges is at the free throw line with 10 points now in the contest.
Let's see if that'll light the nice burst there for the Lady Cards.
That was all predicated by the mystery corner by the Yardbirds. Rebound went to the Lady Cardinals, and they quickly got the ball to the offensive end to Mahogany Williams. 68-24, 7:14 left in the third quarter. Free throw attempt is good.
Lady Cards has come back and hit three in a row. Three throws down, or five in a row.
After missing their first four.
Yeah.
Not a lot of energy in the building today. So even from the announcers, I would hesitate to say. Sorry. Rebound is put back. It's no good. Kay Clark with a wild pass down the floor. He finds Mahogany Williams, and Mahogany Williams gets the bucket off the assist from Kay Clark. Mahogany Williams, all of a sudden, Tim has 13 points in the contest.
She went Clayton Kershaw on that. That was a nice windup delivery. But put on the mark. Well done.
I started to say Nolan Ryan, but then you'd be like, talk about how old I am. So I.
Oh, you're old. Oh, a nice runner. Oh, a nice runner by Gerardo.
That was nice by Eduardo. Not as nice as the comeback by you, I would say, but.
Maylin Wilkerson for three. She's now got 17 points in the contest, 3 3-pointers.
We've seen her do that from behind the stripe, the 3-point line, numerous times this year. She'll just get in the zone and she can fill it up in a hurry.
She's had 7 in one game and 6 in another game.
Three this afternoon.
Get
Brown that time.
Alexis Brown really charged with the foul. That's going to bring Noelle Yancey to the contest for Alexis. she's letting Noelle's hand coming out, and she knocked the heck out of it.
Noelle looked back like, hey,
what are you doing?
I'm trying to get fired up.
She won't offer her hand anymore, I don't think. Every attempt is up and good.
So with a 5:44 to go here, Lady Cards. We were talking coming over this thing about, hey, you got a 7-man squad today. Stay out of foul trouble. They've done that. They've done a great job of, you know, just the positive, making that a non-factor, if you will.
Mahogany Williams with a power move. Shot is blocked. There's Noelle Yancey battling for the rebound and the putback and draws the foul. Noelle Yancey.
And I want to give you credit, Vinny, because about things were moving well, and they have continued, you know, with fouls and that kind of thing. And I may have really double jinxed it now, but I mean, they have, both teams have really continued to get up and down the floor.
And I think the officials are also, unless it's just so obvious or just they see what's going on in the game, there's no sense in making a free throw contest.
Absolutely.
The Rivera Bulldogs have arrived on scene. They're going to their locker room for the 4 p.m. contest against the Cardinals. Coastal Bend with a runner. No good. Number 4 put up the shot. Asia Wheeler. Lady Cards quickly down the floor and quickly out of bounds. Michaela Hutchinson looked at Precious eyes and said, my bad. And Precious didn't respond. I don't know what Precious was thinking. You're right.
I couldn't see her lips, but I think she said, it wasn't my bad. For sure.
77-27, Lady Cards. Nice spinning drive. Move blocked by Noelle Yancey, but that was a very nice move by Brianna Martinez.
Yeah, Martinez with that good move to the basket, but during that, Yancey's able to regather it.
And we're going to have a media timeout in the 4:48 mark of the third quarter. Lady Cards 77, Coastal Bend 27. We'll step away and rejoin you coming out of the timeout. We'll be right back. play out of a media timeout, Tim, with the 7-7 Lady Cardinals. They were 64-22 at the halftime, so still being all Lady Cardinals, although maybe not quite as fluid as the first 2 quarters.
Got a first quarter 35 coming out. And you had the feeling.
You look at what the Lady Cards did in the second half down at Jacksonville. They only allowed 14 points, and they only allowed 10 points here in the first quarter of this one.
That's pretty impressive. And there's a good reason right there, as you see Kay Clark almost picking the pocket. Another steal.
Coastal Bend will continue to own possession of the basketball. At the halfway point now of the third quarter, just under it anyway. Kay stalking the ball. It gives, if it's on the floor, Kay now Clark is going to get it. Now, she traveled with it, but if it's on the floor, Kay Clark is on the floor with it.
I was going to say, and it takes a nanosecond for her to make that decision. She is cat-like quick on top of that and immediately there.
There aren't many certainties in this world, but that's one of them. If the ball's on the floor, Kay Clark is on the floor with it.
Great effort. Great effort.
She will definitely miss her after her time as Lady Cardinals up. Going to be a foul underneath. I think it's probably going to be against Michaela Hutchinson. Yep, it sure is. She picked up one early on, and that's just her second, so she's done a good job of playing with the one foul up to this point. Really, I don't think the fouls are going to be a problem for Precious Ivy. I'm not even worried about jinxing it, because, I mean, I think they could play with four and be okay. Free throw attempt is good. Knocked down by number 12, Savannah Smith. Savannah came in averaging 12 points a game, and that's just her third quarter of the contest.
That's a good job, again, speaking to the defensive effort, keeping her down and not able to even get to that average.
I think I said she came in averaging 12 points a game. She came in averaging 16 points
a game. Wow.
Mahogany gives it up down low to a wide open Michaela Hutchinson.
They're from Mahogany.
Lady Carter's done that several times today of anticipating and knowing where their teammate was underneath the goal.
See if they come out, keep working here on the other end, and they have all afternoon.
Three-pointer rims in and out. Hey, Clark settles and grabs a rebound, and now is going to push the ball to the offensive end, gives it up to Mae Lynn. Mae Lynn's going to go the distance with the lay it up and lay it in. Mae Lynn to
count that, the freshman from Houston.
Mae Lynn now with 19 points in the contest.
And her fifth here in the second half.
She was the first player signed on this Lady Cardinal team of the newcomers this year. She signed last November. November was a year ago.
Great hand, got a piece of that.
Kay Clark running the floor. Lady Cards have numbers. Mahogany Williams lays it up and in.
Mahogany
got it with 15 points.
Oh, you're good. Mahogany caught herself underneath there and had to do a good job adjusting, but presence of mind put it up and through. Excellent.
Three-pointer on the way. In and out.
Well, you're relentless on the defensive side.
Kay Clark pulls the trigger on another long pass. Merrill Yancey tries to give it up to Maylin Wilkerson, but a nice job of reading the Lady Cards by Wheeler. I'm sorry, by Smith. Smith lays it up. Smith lays it in. Now her numbers are starting to creep up there. Now she's got 6 points, not quite at her 16-point average. Lady Card is quickly down the floor. Michaela Hutchinson lays it up and lays it in.
And they do excellent job there to take back that two they gave up on the other end. Oh, nobody helped there.
Put back is good by number 34, Miranda Lamb, and there's a foul, a whistle. Underneath, we're going to have a timeout call. Going to have a media timeout at the 2:32 mark, Tim. Let's just keep it right here, 85-33, and remind folks, I should say, we will have the Cardinals versus the Bear coming up at 4 p.m. in a very key contest for the Cardinals, who have won 9 straight, lead the conference. The Bear is 6-4, and the Bear started the season ranked number 10. They are number 16, and the Cardinals with the Fulton Cannon beat them 91-95 in the ranked 16.
That was a big win, and that kind of really picked things up for them at that point. They moved on it. Not eight straight, so that's excellent there. We'll have number 2 on the side. So looking over the stats right now, Lady Cardinals continue to pour it on here. They've got 19. We'll be right back.
Cardinals. Will be Lady Cardinal basketball. That was a media timeout here. Ball's quickly inbounded to Kay Clark, and we're underway. Kay with a lengthy floor pass. And she's had several of those today. Noelle thought about the three. Gives it up to Kay Clark. Kay thought about the three. Kay instead drives and lays it up, and Kay lays it in.
Kay Clark, going to have to ice the shoulder, though, just like Kershaw after the ball game.
She's got 9 points in the contest.
Yeah, she's played excellent.
So Kay has nine, and Alexis has seven. They're the only two Lady Cardinals that have played today that aren't in double digits, so there's still plenty of chances for them to get in double digits, and have all seven players in double digits. Maylin Wilkerson for three, rims out.
Well, that looked like it was 90% down, but he got hold 100%. It bounced out at the end.
Three-pointer on the way. Knocked it down. No nice doubt touch about that one. DiArdo came in averaging 11 points a game. She's got the eight. There's a steal quickly by number 10, but she misses the layup.
They want to push.
Hey, gives it up to Kiana. Kiana with the putback, and she can't get it to fall. Boy, she's missed a ton of those putbacks today. Don't get me wrong, folks. She's got 12 points.
Yeah, I had a lot of point blank that she's not able to come down.
So the foul's going to go against Michaela Hutchinson. We have free throw shot by Savannah Smith. Smith, as I've mentioned a couple times, is averaging 16 points a game, and she's got six in the contest. She'll go to the free throw line to shoot two as Alexis Brown checks into the contest for Michaela Hutchinson of the Lady Cards.
So that 87 number here been stuck there for about a minute or so. Let's think of how good it would be to hit the 100 mark. In three quarters. Don't know if they're going to be able to make it now.
Yeah, that might be a stretch.
Called the Jets about a minute ago.
Lady Cards have scored, 23 points in this quarter, which would be the slowest quarter of the contest as far as scoring goes.
Coastal's been able to put some points together here down the stretch. 87-38 now.
They land. She didn't look to shoot the three. She was, their Lady Cards are trying to burn some clock here. Ball's out top to Kay. Kay with the pull-up jumper. Kay knocks it down. That's a two.
Okay, Clark. My goodness. Nice.
Kay now in double digits. So that leaves Alexis Brown with seven as the only Lady Cardinal not in double digit scoring. I don't know that I've ever covered a game, ever. Every player that played, and granted there's only seven, that scored in double digits.
This would be a first for me if they can pull that off.
Kay Clark almost got a steal. Ooh, a long three-pointer. Just no good. And the foul's going to go against Noel Yancey, who got caught out of control. And going to be charged with the foul.
Good coaching there from you hear it over on from Coach Precious. She's like, secure the rebound. First things first. You know, get that rebound. Didn't get that offense transition because it ended up being points on the other end plus a foul. And now if you don't have a 50-point lead.
Do the math, Tim. Come on. That's an easy number up
the
there.
The number change, it was like 38. I was going, and then it went 39. It's like, now it's 50? Okay. But if that 50 is not 50, I mean, you're picking up points and foul and all that. But anyway, I'll start with getting the rebound.
Graves hit one or two free throws for Coastal Bend. Lady Cardinals go on the attack. Going to play for the final shot of the third quarter. Kay Clark gives it up to Alexis Brown. Alexis Brown lays it up, and Alexis lays it in.
Good job to use the body and keep her off as it's not able to get to the ball.
And we are at the end of three, folks, here at Leon's Pitcher Coordinator Cardinal Gym. The Lady Cardinals 91, Coastal Bend 39. Be back in just a moment. Welcome back to Leon Spencer Court at Cardinal Gym. Going to the fourth quarter of the Super Bowl Conference contest. We're Lady Cardinal 91, Coastal Bend 39. I'm Jim Rutherford, Tim Howard, and Tim. The Lady Cardinals now, this was decided. Everybody gets it. You're playing seven players, and you can't afford to lose another player.
Players on the sideline for this one this afternoon. But having said that, you've got seven players in the contest today. Six of them have scored double figures already. Can they get that seventh in double figures?
And Alexis Brown, number one, has got nine, so she's not that far off. So we'll see how that plays out. Lady Cardinals with the ball first. Kiana Anderson down low. Kiana can't get it to fall. Boy, she cannot get a roll today.
Well, that is unfortunate there. That was a pretty good-looking opportunity missed.
Shot on the way. Knocked it down. That's a deuce.
And you mentioned the Lady Cougars. They have had a pretty nice quarter there. They had 17 coming out with another bucket there to start the fourth.
Yeah, easily their most productive quarter is Maylin gives it up to Kiana, and Kiana misses it, and that's going to bring in Mahogany Williams. I think Precious wants to settle down. Kiana just a little bit on those short shots that she's missing. Refocus a little bit. Noelle Yancey on the defense that time doesn't come away with the steal, but forces a ball to go out of bounds off of her.
How tough is it if you're Coastal and you have a couple of back-to-back runs, you got the ball in your back, and you look up and it's 91-41.
I just want the game to get over with.
You do.
Oh, what a block by Mahogany Williams, and Alexis Brown is going to get into double digits, and all seven Lady Cardinals are now in double digits for the game.
Wow.
That's pretty impressive, folks.
Very impressive.
It doesn't matter who you're playing or what you're playing.
You do that in the backyard, that's impressive.
And the Lady Cougars turn it over.
Mahogany she goes in there and just changes things. You start going in, you see her rising up. Ball goes magically off her knee as you're trying to go the hoop. So it all takes its toll. Lady Cards in control here with 8.5 to go in this one.
The Lady Cardinals' high water mark as far as points this year is the 101-10 scored against Bossier Parish in the last home game that they played. Kate Clark can't get the ball. Mahogany Williams gets the putback.
Good job there. Be in the right place, right time. Make it happen.
Mahogany now has 17 points in the contest. Lady Cardinals continuing to defend.
Yeah, they're working. They have not checked out of this one.
Three-pointer, no good. Quickly to the offensive end. Noelle Yancey for three. Deuce. It's on the line. Noelle Yancey, third deuce.
Now cut it in the stride, though. Goes up. You love seeing that. Stepping up, knocking it down.
Noelle with 15 points. Nice shot on the three-pointer, by the way, on the way. Number 34, Miranda Lamb. She had 13 coming to the season, to the game. I know she's hit two in this one.
And a good touch there.
Noel takes it all the way, high off the glass, lays it in.
Well, I kind of look back like, wait, you're not even arguing? A little bit offended there.
Kay Clark with the steal. Sounding like a broken record there. Kay lays it up. Kay can't get it to fall. Mahogany's there, though, and she gets the good ball. Mahogany Williams now with 19 points in the contest.
In here with 7 minutes to go.
Michaela Hudson is going to check back into the contest for the Lady Cards. That's as Brown got a hand on the ball. Still 6:47 left in this one. Three-pointer on the way. Oh, that was a prayer, but it wasn't answered. Nice runner that time by number 12, Savannah Smith. Savannah now with 10 points in the contest. She might get you her average of 16 points.
She very well could.
Lady Cards quickly to the offensive end. Noelle Yancey with a little power move. Doesn't get the shot to fall, but does draw the foul. Noelle will have to only get the free throw spot. Noelle will go to the free throw line with 10 with 17 points.
Yeah, Noelle chance to work with that 20-point echelon. She can knock down a couple here.
She's averaging right at 12 a game, 11.6, so well beyond that.
Two other big games going on today on the women's side. You got Blinn at Tyler and Kilgore's at Panola's. We're trying to get a score on those. If we get a score, we're passing along. Well, Yancey knocks down the first free throw to give her 18. If she makes this one, she will match Maylin Wilkerson and Mahogany Williams with 19. Now, Dinkster does Mahogany Williams to clear the rebound and releases it out of bounds, which is going to say it goes out of bounds off of Coastal Denver.
Wow. So the Cards keep possession here. They're 6 of 11 unofficially at the free throw line this afternoon.
But Tiana Anderson checks it back into the contest. 3-point on the way to Hutchinson. No good. There's Kay Clark with the rebound. The putbacks draws a foul, but does not fall. So it'll be interesting to see if Tiana Anderson fares a little better inside after getting kind of refocused by Precious Ivy during that timeout.
Yeah, I think that's definitely why she got cut out. Just get her back in the zone.
Kay Clark knocks down the free throw. Kay's got 12 in the contest. We'll run down the Lady Cardinals scoring before we sign off today, folks, because they've got all seven players in double digits.
Clark knocks that one down, so she's had her average, averaging 13.9 a game.
6 minutes to go in this one. 104. Oh, nice job of cutting to the bucket by Martinez, and she gets the bucket to fall. She's got 4 in the contest for Coastal Bend. Noelle Yancey for 3. Noelle Yancey for 3.
Yeah.
She now has 21 points in the contest to lead the Lady Cardinals. She's got 3 3-pointers. Well, almost comes away with a steal. Kay Clark comes away with a steal, and it will be a wide open layup.
Never had a more wide open layup than that. Except maybe in practice, maybe. Just knocked it all away from the defender and then clear sailing.
So the Lady Cardinals' high water mark on the season for points is 110. That's certainly going to fall here in the final 5 minutes, or Precious Ivy's going to have to be pulled out of this place.
They have played some excellent ball today.
Coastal Bend turns it over. Lady Cardinals put up 64 in the first half.
64 in the first half, so they're well on their way to finishing this thing here.
Taylor finds Kiana underneath. Kiana misses a little short shot underneath. Kay Clark gives it up to Noelle. Noelle puts it up, and Noelle puts it in.
Clark is so strong to the basket. Just eyes in the back of the head all around. She knew immediately. She's looking her off and knows underneath. And now the beneficiary, Yancey.
Noelle Yancey's got 23 points in the first matchup against Coastal Bend. She did not score in double digits, so she has made the most today against Coastal Bend. And we are at 111 to 48 at the 455 mark. The Lady Cardinals have now scored more points in the season. This is the postseason.
Yeah, absolutely.
And to do, to you know, to get back full strength, hopefully before, you know, that time comes, we shall see.
Noelle Yancey to the free throw line. Try to complete the and one. And she does. So Noelle now with 24 points in the contest. Okay, Clark had come away with a steal.
I was ready to go ahead and call it.
Not very excited about it.
You see her do it so often, you thought, well, there's another steal for Kay. So here are our backpacks now.
Coastal Bend with a 3-pointer on the way. Banks it in. I don't know if she called it or not. Number 10 comes away with a 3-pointer, Brianna Martinez.
I asked her when she runs by. Brianna, did you call it? She did call glass.
Brianna Anderson, bless her heart. Well, she does a great job of throwing the ball out of bounds, and she's frustrated now,
yeah,
folks.
She's thinking about it.
She's just not gotten any rows today inside, and she's working hard and getting open and getting shots and getting putbacks, so she's not lack of effort.
Guys, just keep battling. Good things will happen.
And Alexis Brown for three, short. Rebound Yancey. Yancey with the putback. Can't get it to fall. Kay Clark over the back. She's going to be called for the foul. 112-51 Lady Cards. 4:18 left in the contest.
Final 4 minutes, maybe the longest four of the day.
It may be. Some of the Lady Cards was just one team foul and close to being the three. As Alexis Brown comes away with a steal. Alexis running the floor, kicks it out to Kay. Kay with the jumper, no good. Backside rebound, it goes to Hutchinson. She gives it up to Noelle. Noelle back inside to Michaela. Michaela gives it up to Kiana. Oh. Kiana puts it up, and Kiana puts it up.
Yeah, good hustle all the way around. Getting it done.
14 points for Kiana. We talked to her, she's missed so many shots today, and she has, and she can't, and she wouldn't deny that, but she does have 14 points. I like the way the Lady Cards are continuing to work on defense.
I do too, because you know what? That's something that you're going to need down the stretch. And I think they know that moving forward. They're like, we've got to step up every aspect.
Oh, Yancey tried to knock down another three. Hey. Kay Clark battling for the rebound.
Oh.
Gives it up to Michaela Hutchinson. She's going to go out of bounds off his personal bend. Going to be 16 seconds on the shot clock. As Williams and Wilkerson are going to check back into the contest for Lady Cards.
I'll just tell you, Kay Clark there dribbling on her knees. The old Curly Neal of the Harlem Globetrotters comes to mind. If I'm going to have the old man tag, I might as well use it, right?
Exactly.
Just some references.
Mahogany Williams with a power move, and she puts it up and puts it in.
Nicely done. Mahogany going strong.
Mahogany with 21 points in the contest.
Good effort all the way around today, guys. Ladies.
Three-pointer no good. Rebound goes to the Lady Cougars, but their block is by Mahogany Williams. Puts it down the floor to come from the Lady Cards. Alexis Brown tries to give it up to Mahogany, but it's going to be a turnover and steal by number 23, Jaden Eaton, for the Lady Cougars. And a lot of steps in there, but the foul is going to be called against the Lady Cards. Noelle Yancey is going to be charged with the foul. That's going to be her third personal foul.
A lot of up and down in that back and forth to get to the basket. Like you said, a lot of steps. But does draw the foul and chance to add points at the line. Misses the first one.
Jay Neaton misses the free throw. The freshman out of Houston, Texas, 5'3". Hasn't played a lot in this contest today, but she's trying to make the most of her opportunity now, I should say. 7 free throw attempt is good. Lady Cards are inbound. Quickly get the ball to the offensive end to Alexis Brown. Over to Noelle Yancey. Noelle thought about the three, turned it down.
Very, very methodical here with the ball. Trying to be very selective on a little half-court offense clock.
Brown directing the show. She's done so most of the day. Three-pointer on the way. Knocked it down. Malian Wilkerson. Now with 14 points in the contest, her second three-pointer, she hit one real early in the game, and now she's going to close out the game with at least one more.
Nice touch here from Wilkerson.
Well, Lady Cards go to sleep there. Let number 12, Savannah Smith, drive it all the way in. Well, Yancey with the pull-up jumper, can't get it to fall. 119-54 Lady Cards, 145 and counting in the contest.
Oh,
and
boy.
The Lady Cougs throw it away.
Had a opportunity there and got a big old vision there. A little too much on that one.
So the Lady Cardinals about to improve to 9-2 overall, 6-2 in the conference. Protect their number 4 national ranking, though that's going to change, I'm sure, after having lost Monday night to Panola in overtime 67-65. And Precious Ivy wants to call a timeout. Going to be a full timeout, see something she wants to adjust here, which is a coach, you're always coaching.
Always coaching and always, you know, these are times you got a chance to really zone it in, lock it in, and say, hey, here's something that we can use down the stretch. Let's work on this in the final 94 seconds.
Lady Cards will be on the road Wednesday night going to Brenham to take on a very good Glenn team. The first time around, Lady Cards will be with Glenn here. So, Glenn didn't have a very good shooting game that night, and they're very good in three points. They got plenty of depth. Of course, next Saturday you will have the weekend in college trying to win the college ball. You could be like 42 points. You know that.
That's definitely that's the
ceiling gave way at Wax Step. There was a leak, if I was to call. They had to stop it to play.
Got a 20-minute delay, yeah.
See if they can avenge that one next Saturday.
So here we go. The final 1:30 left in this one. Lady Cardinals. Brown thought about the three. Gives it up inside to Anderson. Going to be a jump ball. Possession error is going to belong to Coastal Peninsula. It'll go down as a turnover against the Lady Cards. Started to say, Lady Cards are lining up to throw it in. I said, if I can read the arrow correctly, and I know I can't do a lot of things, but I can still see an arrow. I've only been drinking water today. Coastal Bend. First matchup between these two teams, Tim, was 106-46. So Coastal Bend has actually done better on the offensive end. They do that night. Mahogany's going to take it and lay it up and lay it in.
Oh, my goodness. Coast to coast. LA to Chicago. Take it now.
Mahogany Williams now with 23 points in the contest. And Coastal Bend turns it out.
Noelle gets the block, and she stepped out of bounds. Went up literally nicely done.
So the Lady Cards can't dribble it out. They're not to that point just yet. But this 121-54 Lady Cards.
She's a high mark here. Denny, what's the highest point?
I knew you were going to ask me that, and I can't tell you off the top of my head. The 143 jumps out at me, but I'm not sure. Kay Clark for three, no good. Noelle Yancey battles for the rebound, gives it up to Kiana. Kiana lays it up. Kiana lays it in with 16 points now. Kiana Anderson.
Well, Denny, I knew you were not going to ask me that question.
I knew it was coming from you, though.
Go straight up with the hands.
I've got to look that one up just to know it again.
That's impressive. Today's definitely a high-scoring affair.
Lady Cardinals now with the dribble out. Final score is going to be 123-54 Lady Cards. Lady Cards score 22 points in that final quarter. Coastal Bend scores 15. Our final score for the announcement for the Cardinals is going to be 123-54, but I want to run down to Lady Cardinals score before we close the game. Alexis Brown had 14. Layla Wilkinson had 19. Kiana Anderson had 16. Noelle Yancey had 18. I'm sorry, Noelle Yancey had 24. Harvey Williams had 23. Kayla Clark had 15. And Kayla Hutchinson had 12. Lady Cardinals improved with 9-2, 6-2 in conference play. Coastal Bend improves to a fall, I should say, 22 overall. 1-5 in conference play. We're going to have a men's game against the Bears coming up before you here in about 25 minutes. So we hope you will be joining us on the College Sports Network. For Tim Howard, this is Kenny Rogers saying so long for now. We're not looking forward to that.